So we are in Parag Dalet, the fourth parag of Derech Zuta, up to Ozain in the edition of the Derech Haim. Ein alim schar di betorah. So you can't take money to for Torah. Pashas to learn and to teach. V'matan lo tel schar, if you take away money, that means a machri was called chulo. You destroy the entire world. Very harsh words. So the Derech Haim says, by taking money to teach Torah, you have made a determination, or at least presented the presentation, that the Torah is not worthy to teach to others unless you can gain an advantage from it. So that's the case of Shem. Mida Kenega Mida is going to reciprocate and conduct himself accordingly. To only give the Torah for his benefit. And Hashem's benefit from Torah is not in this world. He doesn't need the human form of the Torah. So he doesn't need divine form of the Torah either. But so he does not need the human form, which is has to do with Basar Badab. Where the secrets of it are revealed to those who learn it. In say Machri was called Kulo. This goes Olam Hazat down here below. Baruch is going to choose to be in the higher realm, which is more advantageous to him. That's a very cute interpretation. It's certainly not a Pashup Shot. The Pashup Shot is that you're Machri Ba'olamo because you're being Machal Shem Shemayim. Because you're doing things in which show that Torah is a kardam lachborba, is a tool by which you make money, not something which is given to make the world a better place and you be a better people. But that's an interesting shot. And along these lines, he says, "Noruch Chaim," because I'm on Shabbos. I'm Rabbi Shimon Levi. Shalom, Moshe Lamaro. When Moshe went up to Shemayim, Amar Alecha Shos Nekosh Bavul. The Malachim said before Hashem, "Mal Yehud Yisha Beneinu. Why should this human being be among us?" Amar LeKabel Torah. He came to get the Torah. Amulei, they said, Malachim said to Hashem, Chem Dagnuza, the sin and treasure, Tatka Doros, for the 974 generations before the world's created, after Mevakshali Din Lebnos Badom. You keep trying to give it to human beings. Minoshki is going, what are human beings you should remember them? Tal Chol Shmai, put your glory on heaven. Amulei, Kosh Baruch Moshe, Hashem said to Moshe, Hashem, Tshuva, respond to them. Amulei, Farmer said, Rebunshu, Mishan, Hashem, Yisufri, Bevel, P.M. I'm afraid that they're going to burn me with the fire of their mouths. Amalei, so Hashem said, Achos, because he said, Kvodi, hold on to my throne of glory. I mean, Bunashah. He said, Moshe said to Hashem, Torah Shatanos in the Maxibe. What does it say in this Torah? Lo Yel Cholim Achen. Well, Seer Tzach, we'll see enough all these things. Kum Yetzor Yeshmeyechem, do you, Malach Yeshua, have a Yetzor? Kamalasi Ben Kambur Bafike. That's the name one of his other sparring, but Safiki, something or other. He closed the Torah Shtaim. There are two levels of Torah. Chine Chelek Elyon, Chelek Hamitz, there's the, sorry, Chine Chelek Eiv. There's a part of learning, analysis, Chelek Mitzvah, and a part of doing, commandments. Chine Chelek Elyon, in the aspect of learning Torah, Shem Chelek Eiv, which is the aspect of Eiv, but there, now the Olam Elyon Al Haaretz, that the higher realms of spirits in this realm, obviously, because Kibazen Ki Ainis Alek Vodis Baruch Ba'asogas Tachtonim, because Kodesh Baruch Hu's honor is not properly perceived down here below. Ach Bechelak Hamitzvah, but in terms of doing, Bezem Is Alek Vodis Baruch Ba'asogas, but that in that respect, Hashem's honor is uplifted more down here. Abchirim Yosef, where people need to make choices. More may I should now a million where people do the right thing automatically, almost people, not people, malachim. So when the malachim said the glory of Hashem should be in heaven, excuse me, Moshe didn't know a good answer to give them, but I'm wrong. He said, "Mishani Hashem Mitzvah, we have a PM. I pray they're gonna burn me with the fire of their mouths." Hainu, meaning, but Talmud, Chelek Limud Torah Shemavim. with their learning, which is in their mouths. Without they can burn me. Their perception and part of Eon is much more superior to ours down here below. In my throne. There's a place for the tshuva to grab hold. And overcome them. It's a very nice pshat he's saying here, I must say. In terms of the uplifting of my throne of glory, in the part of Torah down below, in a way which is greater than on high, they might say it's in the portion of doing the mitzvahs. What does it say? That's on below. By us, there's Bechira. In terms of the part of mitzvah, we're superior. That's a very nice shot. I like it a lot. Let's see the next one here. Also in the Orchos Chaim. The Gemara Meseches Tanya, Tanya, Rabbi Ben Bno, Omer, Mino said, Kol Tzim B'Tol Lishmo, who in Torah for the right reasons, Nasi Tzol Tzim B'Chaim comes to him, an elixir of life, Shnei Mei Tzim B'Machazi Yibam, the tree of life for those who hold on to it. Kol Tzim B'Tol Shalo Lishmo, people in Torah, not for the right reasons, Nasi Tzim B'Machazi comes an elixir of death, Shnei Mei Arov, Kam Al it'll come down and ring necks, like rain, and Rifal Arei, Rigo, Shnei Mei Yarfu Sa'egla, like Arifas Egla Rufa. Shaisa B'Torah Lishma. We learn B'Torah Lishma, which he defines here. Hain Shalom L'Shem Toelas HaChozer. Not to get a reciprocal advantage. He can show faith, but that totally clearly indicates in his mind. She a totally no saying below. Shalom L'Shem Toelas HaNosein. That the Torah should be given, can be given without advantage to the giver. In other words, he's not doing it. The advantage is not the reason to do it. That's the case. Hashem did well giving Torah for nothing in this world. The royal miskayim. It's appropriate for the world to be sustained. When King Garim says, "Sam chayim came home," so the elixir of life is the sustaining of the world. By learning Torah Shalom Lishma, you are seem to be stating that Torah is only valuable when you get some advantage from it. In that case, the world should be destroyed. Hashem doesn't gain advantage from learning Torah down here below if its purpose is to make it a plow with which to plow. And that causes it to be a elixir of death to destroy the entire world. Okay, I like the first one better. He goes on with several things here. I don't think we have to do more than this. Oh, no, this one I want to do. This one I like. Actually, there's a little mark too by this. But Meta Shriver, Shimon Ben Levi. It's actually Machlok, it's between the Midrashim. But here it says that the cloth of Torah, which was given to Moshe, was a white fire, and the writing was a black fire. The aspect of Torah, which it was given to Moshe to bring down to the world, nismayt hora sagasa, its light was diminished. There was in heaven. He must have skipped, said this previously and missed it. That in Shemayim it says it's Suva Eish Levana Agabe Eish Shechora, the other way around. In other words, when it comes down to Eretz, it's black fire and white fire. In heaven, it's white fire and black fire. And that's to say, the whole is much more Shemayim. Lechem Eser Shalaisa Ora Eish Levana. No, he's not going with the two Midrashim. She's going to this one matter. She's not going to the cannot compare and contrast Midrashim. He's saying that in Torah, it's like in heaven, it's like white light, and then the black light was superimposed on it. As he's saying, Hem Tarot Sol Shalit, Ora Eish, Levana, Meir Masir Mod, tremendously brilliant. Kaslav Eish Chora, Mamid Zora, Eish Halavana Shatachlav. He read on it in blood, but in black fire, which diminishes the radiance of light in order to make it suitable to give in this world. Okay. Let's see the next part here. Ches, altamar eli mama. Don't say I have no money. She called mama shalo. All the money's God's anyway. She never kesev liyazav amar Hashem tzavos. All belongs to me. Says Zerachaim, altamar me'aroy shekach schara teira. So he says going on the previous. And don't say I'm so poor I gotta take money for it. Ainly mamon bilado, otherwise not gonna have any money. The yotzer by shulah kaschal atar. If Hashem didn't want me to take reward for what I must be limon mamacher. He'll give me money from elsewhere. Bilti sofek, without a doubt, shkam nasa ritzono. But his intent is that shekach sami Torah. That he should take money for the Torah. Shere davar kein. Not true. Shemale hayis tliya hasogas hamamon b'koach adam atzmo matzei adav. It's where the money you would accumulate in this world have to do with your own efforts. It could be possible to say, since I have no other way to obtain money except for learning Torah, so I have to take money for Torah. But the truth is, all the money belongs to him. And he gives it to whoever he pleases. Without the will of God, no cause which you employ is going to be effective. Maybe he doesn't want you to have money, and then even if you take money for learning Torah, you're not going to be able to keep it. It's going to go away. Okay, I think the next part of the test is a slightly different topic, so we'll leave that for next time.